This is a brief lecture identifying the health and safety considerations when dealing with UAVs. Much of the content may have been raised during other lectures. As such, please treat this lecture as a refresher on previously covered subjects, whilst also providing some depth to topics only briefly highlighted. In this lecture, we will be looking at the health and safety considerations when dealing with the following UAV-related dangers. And those are propeller blades, lithium polymer batteries, firearms and explosives, and payloads. Propeller blades. Whilst covered in the previous lecture, the greatest, or rather the most likely risk you may encounter will involve propeller blades. The spinning propeller of a UAV can cause slashing damage to the skin, concussion, and pain and discomfort. As we can see from this 2015 video during an Enrique Iglesias concert, the singer can be seen to hold a UAV whilst the propeller blades are still spinning. The singer appears to be looking towards the mounted camera and allowing the downdraft of the propeller blades to blow over him, clearly for dramatic effect. However, the singer's hand is caught by one of the blades, and it evidently caused him some discomfort. It turned out that one brief contact caused the singer to suffer a fracture to his hand, which needed to be corrected in addition to reconstructive surgery. Whilst the singer should be applauded for continuing, it is clear by the amount of blood that this was a significant injury. Given the weight and speed of some UAVs, it is apparent that any dealings should be taken with care, and where possible, the blade should be removed prior to any examination. Lithium polymer batteries. Lithium polymer batteries, often abbreviated to LiPo batteries, are a significant advancement in battery technology. However, due to the chemistry of lithium cells, there is the possibility of fire or explosion if charging is not done properly. The following simple rules and precautions should assist in limiting the associated risks. Batteries should never be left unattended whilst charging. Be absolutely sure that the lithium polymer charger settings are correct for the battery pack being charged, that being both the voltage and current settings. Lithium polymer must be charged and stored in a fire-safe container, like a LiPo bag. Do not charge batteries near flammable items or liquids. Keep a dry fire extinguisher nearby. Never charge inside your car, even when parked. Never leave batteries inside a car on a hot day or any other place where temperatures may reach 60 degrees. and keep batteries away from children and pets at all times. In relation to the connections, be sure that the correct polarity is observed when connecting battery packs to the charger. Do not put the loose cells in a pocket, bag, or drawer where they could short circuit against other items, or the battery tabs could be pressed against each other. Do not place the loose cells on any conductive surface, such as a metal table top. Take care that the cells are not punctured, especially by metallic objects. If the electrolyte in the cells were to get on your skin, thoroughly wash with soap and water. If in the eyes, rinse thoroughly with cool water. Immediately seek medical attention for this. Firearms and explosives. UAVs have been used by ISIS since 2014 for the use in propaganda videos, as a command and control platform, and as a munitions deployment resource. However, as we have seen earlier in this course, the history of UAVs has not been without a level of violence. As we saw in the previous video, UAVs have increasingly been experimented with in combination with firearms, explosives, flamethrowers. Additionally, they have been adapted for industrial use, which have included the ability to fire a nail gun. This is to be expected and must be taken into consideration when dealing with a UAV. In the majority of cases, the UAV will be at its factory condition, with possibly a few modifications, with load carrying being the majority of cases I have dealt with. However, any UAV related incident must involve a dynamic risk assessment, with consideration given to offensive and defensive modifications. Payloads. As previously stated, UAVs traditionally are not designed to carry a payload, with the exception of a camera. As such, any payloads found to be connected to a UAV must be treated with caution. So far, the majority of cases where a UAV has been used in a criminal or nefarious purpose have involved the transporting of illicit items into restricted areas, which have primarily been prisons. As such, care should be taken when dealing with such payloads, as they will likely contain needles, drugs, and other paraphernalia, along with mobile devices. In most of these scenarios, the UAVs will have crashed within the prison grounds, meaning that their payloads of drugs and needles are exposed and could cause injury to anyone seizing it. With the increase in modifications, especially where UAVs have been used for industrial purposes, further risks are created, like those inherent to any industrial workspace. Nail guns are the new attachment to UAVs which carry their own risks. These UAVs could be used on roofing projects, on building sites. However, if one were to crash, there would be the potential for the nail gun to fire in a random direction, which could cause damage, injury, or even a fatality. Whilst much less likely, consideration must also be given to more extreme payloads, including explosive and chemical. The type of incident you may be called to, or be required to conduct an examination on, could include a targeted attack or terrorist incident. In an era where UAVs have been used by terrorist organisations and nation-states attacking each other, there is sadly an inevitable conclusion that UAVs will likely be used. A standard UAV, similar to the size and power of a DJI Phantom 4, could carry around 2 to 4 kilograms of weight. 4 kilograms of explosive material, or even 4 kilograms of a chemical agent, could be devastating if used offensively, but would also have additional risks for first responders and forensic agencies. By the end of this lecture, students should have a better understanding of the health and safety risks associated with UAVs, both in a commercial environment and also in a criminal context. As UAVs have become larger, more powerful, and more versatile, the potential for more diverse payloads increases. As such, it is important that dynamic risk assessments are continually carried out to maintain the safety of all those involved in their examination.